This is Dick. Well, today I'm going to teach the accounting treatment of new profit sharing ratio. I mean, how are we going to calculate new profit sharing ratio from the chapter Admission of a Partner. Before we discuss how to calculate new profit sharing ratio, I want you to know the meaning and the reason why we calculate new profit sharing ratio. Okay, student, first tell me, what is new profit sharing ratio? So new profit sharing ratio means the ratio in which all the partners, including new partners, share the future profit of the firm. I repeat, the ratio in which all the partners, including new partners, share the future profit of the firm. So here, all partner means it includes both old partners and new partners share profit. Now, my second point is why we calculate new profit sharing ratio. For this, I'm going to explain with a very simple example. Suppose say A and B are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2, and firm has a profit of ₹50,000 during the year. If we distribute the profit between A and B in their own profit sharing ratio, then A will get how much? 50,000 multiplied by 3/5. So A will get how much? A will get 30,000. And how much you will get? B will get, B's share profit is 2/5. So B will get how much? 20,000. So this is the situation before admission of partner takes place. Now here, what happens is, if A and B admitted new partner, A admitted C as a new partner into the partnership firm, then we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio. The reason why we calculate new profit sharing ratio is A and B are no more going to get the same amount of profit that they used to get earlier, which is 30,000 and 20,000, because they sacrifice a part of their share in favor of C. Suppose say, if the profit of 50,000 is distributed amongst all the partners, including new partners, I mean, if this profit is distributed amongst A, B, and C, then A and B will not get the same profit. They are going to get less profit, like I said before, because they sacrifice a part of their share in favor of new partner, that is C. Therefore, it is very necessary to calculate new profit sharing ratio whenever new partner is admitted. Now, coming to the main topic, that is accounting treatment of new profit sharing ratio. I mean, how are we going to calculate new profit sharing ratio? So, in order to calculate new profit sharing ratio, we have like two main cases, but I'm going to make it four in order to make you understand better. Here we have case number one. First, I'll read the question. A and B are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C as a new partner for 1/5 share in the future profit of the firm. Calculate new profit sharing ratio. So here, A and B are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2, and they admitted whom? They admitted C as a new partner for 1/5 share in the future profit. So here, information is not given with regard to sacrifice made by the old partners. If such question is given, then we have to make an assumption. So here we have to assume one as firm's share of profit. So here firm's share of profit means the share of profit of all the partners, including A partners. I mean the share of A, B and C. So if we deduct C's share, that is 1 by 5 from 1, then we are going to get 4 by 5, which is called remaining share. So this 4 by 5 is shared by A and B in their own profit share ratio. So by doing this, we are going to get all partners' new ratio. Now we are going to find A's new ratio. So A's new ratio, since 4 by 5 is acquired by both A and B in their own ratio, so 4 by 5 is acquired by A. What is A's ratio? 3 by 5. We multiply 4 by 3, we get 12 by 25. Now what about B? B's new ratio is equal to, again, 4 by 5 is acquired by B also. 4 by 5 multiplied by B's share is 2 by 5. So here how much we got? 8 by 25. Now what is C's share? So here C's share is given already. We don't have to find it. And C's share is 1 by 5. Since we are calculating new profit sharing ratio, so we have to convert this fraction into ratio. So in order to convert this fraction into ratio, we have to make all the denominators same. Here we have denominator of 35, here again 25, but here we have only 5. So in order to make denominator same, we have to multiply 5 by 5. If we multiply 5 by 5, we will get how much? 5 by 25. Now all the denominators are same. So whether we multiply 5 by 5 or not, it doesn't make any difference to 1 by 5. If we cancel 5 by 5, again we will get 1 by 5. That's why I multiply 5 by 5 in order to make denominator same. Is that clear for you? Okay. So therefore, new profit sharing ratio of A, B, C is A 12, B 8 and C 5. So new profit sharing ratio A and B is 12 is to 8 is to 5. This is how we calculate new profit sharing ratio for case number 1. Okay, now let's move on to case number 2. Ram and Mohan are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3 to 2. They agree thus as a new partner for 3 by 10 share, which he acquired 210 from Ram and 110 from Mohan. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of Ram, Mohan and thus. So in case number 2, you will find old ratio of Ram and Mohan and new partners share, that is 3 by 10, and information is given with regard to sacrifice made by the old partners, that is Ram and Mohan. Now, here Ram and Mohan are partners. What is the profit sharing ratio? 3 is to 2. And they agreed at home. Thus, for 3 by 10 share. Now see, if thus gets 210 from Ram, which means Ram sacrifices 210 in favor of thus. I repeat it. If thus gets 210 from Ram, which means Ram sacrifices 210 in favor of thus. So here we have got the value of sacrificing ratio of Ram. So Ram's sacrificing ratio is 2 by 10. The same case, thus gets 110 from Mohan, which means Mohan sacrifices 110 to whom? To thus again. show sacrifice ratio of n is 1 by 10. If we have the value of sacrifice ratio of all partners, then we can apply the formula of new ratio, which is new ratio is equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Now here we have to find old partners new ratio by using this formula. R's new ratio is equal to, now what is R old ratio? So R old ratio is 3 by 5. And what is R sacrificing ratio? R sacrificing ratio is 2 by 10. If we did that 2 by 10 from 3 by 5, we have to write denominator same by using LCM. So here, if we did that 2 by 10 from 3 by 5, so in order to make denominator same, we have to multiply 2 by 2. If we multiply 2 by 2, then we will get 10. So 3 multiplied by 2, how much we get? 6 minus 2 divided by 10. Is that clear for you? So the value of R's new ratio is 4 by 10. Then what about N? So N's new ratio is equal to, what is N's old ratio? N's old ratio is 2 by 5 minus, what is N's sacrifice ratio? Here the formula is new ratio is equal to old ratio minus sacrifice. What is the sacrifice ratio of N is 1 by 10. So if we take 1 by 10 from 2 by 10, then we will get how much? 4 minus 1 divided by 10, which is 3 by 10. And here we don't have to find this shape because it is given the question already. So this new ratio is 3 by 10. So here we don't have to make denominator same. Since all the denominators are same, we can directly convert this fraction into ratio. So therefore, new profit sharing ratio of Ram, Mohan and Das is 4:3:3. So this is how we calculate new profit sharing ratio with regard to case number 2. Okay, now look at case number 3. I'll read the question first. P and Q are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted Ram as a new partner. P surrenders 1/4 of his share and Q 1/3 of his share in favor of R. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of P, Q and R. So here, P and Q are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2. And they admitted whom? Ram. They admitted Ram. So here, the information is given with regard to sacrifice made by old partners. So here, P sacrifice ratio. Here, P surrenders or sacrifices 1/4. So here, 1/4 is not the sacrifice ratio, mind you. 1/4 is not the sacrifice ratio. Here, read the sentence carefully. P sacrifices 1/3 of 1/4 of his share. What is his share? 3 by 5. So here we have to multiply. P sacrifice 1/4 of his share. Of his share means what is his share? So it is 3 by 5. So if we multiply 1 by 3, we get 3 by 20. And here Q surrenders 1/3 of his share. Again, 1/3, 1/3 is not the sacrificing ratio. Here, Q sacrifices 1/3 of his share. Of his share means what is Q's share? So we have to multiply by 2 by 6. 2 by 5. Here we got how much? 2 by 18. Now we have got the value of sacrifice ratio of all partners. We can apply the formula of new ratio. What is the formula of new ratio? Old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Okay, one thing I want to tell you is why we deduct sacrificing ratio from old ratio in order to get new ratio. Suppose say P has 10 apples and P sacrifices 2 apples to R. Then the remaining apple is 8. So currently P has 8 apples. Currently means new one. So that's why sacrificing ratio is deducted from old ratio in order to get new ratio. Is that clear for you? Okay. Now we are going to find old partner's new ratio. Now P's new ratio is equal to, what is P's old ratio? 3 by 5 minus what is P's sacrifice ratio? 3 by 20. So we have to deduct 3 by 20 from 3 by 5. So multiply by 4 by 4. So here we got 12 minus 3 divided by 20. Here we got how much? 9 by 20. Now we are going to find Q's new ratio. What is the formula of the ratio? Old ratio. So Q's old ratio is 2 by 5 minus what is Q's sacrifice ratio? It is 2 by 15. So we have to make denominator same in order to deduct 2 by 15 from 2 by 5. So 3 by 3. So here we got 6 minus 2 divided by 15, which is 4 by 15. Now we are going to find R's new ratio. So here R's new ratio is not given. Whether new partner's ratio is given or not, it is not important. If it is given, then it is valid good. If it is not given, then we have to find it out by adding the sacrificing ratio of A and B. I mean, the sum of sacrificing ratio of old partner. So we have to add the sacrificing ratio of P and Q. The sacrificing ratio of P is 3 by 20 and the sacrificing ratio of Q is 2 by 15. So how much is got here? So in order to add this fraction, we have to make denominator the same. So how are you going to make denominator the same? By using LCM. 20 and 15. So 2 times 15, again 15. 5, 2, 5, 3. So here, okay. So we have to multiply. So we have 2 multiplied by 5, multiplied by 2, multiplied by 3. How much we got? 2, 5, 10, 10, 2, 20. Here we got 60. So here we have to make denominator 60. So how are you going to get 60? By multiplying 2 by 2. And here we have to multiply 4 by 4. So here, how much we got? 6 plus, we have to multiply 3 by 3, sorry. So here we got 9 plus 8 divided by 60. So the value is 70 by 60. Since we are calculating new profit sharing ratio, so we have to convert this fraction into ratio. In order to convert this fraction into ratio, what we have to do is we have to make denominator same. So how are we going to make denominator same? By multiplying 3 by 3. So what is the value? 27 divided by 60. Here we have to multiply 4 by 4. So how much? What is the value? 16 by 60. And what about this one? Okay. Since we have got the value of new ratio, we don't have to make, we don't have to convert it. So therefore, new profit sharing ratio of PQR is 27 is to 16 is to 17. This is how we should calculate new profit sharing ratio for case number 3. Okay? Okay, now we are going to discuss case number 4. Tenzin and Sonam are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2. They admit Doji as a new partner for 1/5 share in the future profits of the firm, which he gets equally from Tenzin and Sonam. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of Tenzin, Sonam and Doji. Now, in case number 4, we find old partners ratio and new partners share profit, and information is given regarding sacrifice made by the old partners also. So here, Tenzin and Sonam are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2, and they admitted whom? They admitted Doji. They admitted Doji with 1/5 share in the future profit of the firm, where Doji gets 1/5 equally. Equally means 1:1. If we convert this ratio into fraction, then it will become half by half. So Doji gets 1/5 equally from whom? Equally from Tenzin and Sonam, which means Tenzin sacrifice 1/2 of the 1/5, and Sonam sacrifices again 1/2 of the 1/5. By doing so, we will get the sacrifice ratio of Tenzin and Sonam. Now, this sacrifice ratio is 1/2 of the 1/5. So here we got 1/10. Now, what is sacrifice ratio of S Sonam? S sacrifice ratio is equal to again 1/5. How much we got here? 1/10. Since we have got the value of sacrifice ratio of old partners, we can apply the formula of new ratio. So new ratio is equal to old ratio minus sacrifice ratio. So here we have to find our old partners real new ratio. So what is new ratio of T? T's new ratio is equal to, what is T's old ratio? T's old ratio is 3/5, and minus, what is sacrifice ratio of T? 1/10. So here we got how much? 6 minus 1 divided by 10. So new ratio of T is 5/10. Now we are going to find S new ratio. Now what is S old ratio? S old ratio is 2/5 minus what is S sacrifice ratio, which is 1/10. So here we got how much? 4 minus 1/10. So S new ratio is 3/10. So what is new ratio of D? So since we don't have to find this new ratio, since it is given in the question, so D ratio, this new ratio is 1/5. So here we are finding a new profit sharing ratio. So in order to calculate new profit sharing ratio, we have to convert this fraction into ratio. In order to convert this fraction into ratio, we have to get denominator same. So here we have to multiply 2/2. So how much we get? 2/10. Is that clear for you? Therefore, new profit sharing ratio of Tenzin, Sonam and Doji is 5:3:2. So this is how we calculate new profit sharing ratio regarding case number 4. Now we are done with all the cases regarding calculation of the profit sharing ratio. So before I wind up, I would like to quickly recall the topic that we have discussed today. In case number 1, you will find old partners ratio and new partners share profit, and information regarding sacrifice made by the old partner is not given. Okay, number 1, you have to find, you have to find first remaining share. Once you get the value of remaining share, you can find old partners new ratio. Now, from case number 2 to case number 4, first thing is to calculate sacrifice ratio. After getting sacrifice ratio,
we need to apply the formula of new ratio. So what is new ratio? New ratio is equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. And the remaining procedures for all these three cases are same. Is that clear for you? With this, I would like to draw an end, and I hope you all have gained some knowledge from my video lesson. Thank you very much.